It's the end of an era in Oregon politics. John Kitzhaber, who was re-elected to a fourth term last November and first took office in the state in the early 1980s, bowed to mounting pressure to resign.
Oregonians will see that I have never put anything before my love for and commitment to Oregon and faithfully fulfilling the responsibilities of the public offices I have had the honor to hold. I have always tried to do the right thing, and now the right thing to do is to step aside.
The stunning fall comes amid a growing scandal involving the role of his fiancée, the state's first lady, Sylvia Hayes, and her influence over state business. Investigators are looking into concerns that Hayes advised state employees on energy policy while getting paid by a group advocating for a specific position. The state attorney general has given Hayes 7 days to disclose her private emails regarding state business. This is not the first time controversy has swirled around Hayes. In 1997, she married an Ethiopian immigrant for $5,000 to help him get a green card. She also bought land with an ex-boyfriend that year, allegedly to grow marijuana, but denied financial involvement. Today's news caps a week of will he or won't he speculation. On Wednesday, it seemed Kitzhaber was ready to step down. He requested his designated replacement, Secretary of State Kate Brown, to fly back from Washington, D.C. to Oregon. But then it appeared he had a change of heart. Brown detailed the exchange in a statement Thursday, saying, "I asked him what he wanted to talk about. The governor told me he was not resigning," after which he began a discussion about transition. This is clearly a bizarre and unprecedented situation.